You know what's funny, Max? He wanted to compare the stats here. He didn't see anything in his favourite six on that.
No.
Deep man, man.
No, I didn't.
Deep man, man.
No, because I look. No.
Deep man, man.
Is man all right? Do you know what I did on my phone? I worked on last season's stats.
Hello, everyone, and welcome back to the Final Whistle. Today, we are ranking the best midfielders in the Premier League currently. So, yes, we know some midfielders, some of the best midfielders are injured. So, I say we take into account the last year and a half. So, the half of this season, but also last season, so that we're including everyone. Now, the way this works is that before the video started, we have agreed on six names to be included, and then we will be ranking our top six, putting them in order from sixth place to first place. So, those six midfielders are as followed. And they're midfielders who play as the six, as the eight, and the ten. So, we have Bernardo Silva, Rodri, Kevin De Bruyne, Martin Odegaard, Bruno Fernandes, and I knew I was going to forget one.
Declan Rice.
And we have Declan Rice. How can I forget? So, boys, you've heard the six names. Or, I mean, you knew the six names already.
Yeah.
Who is last place in that six? Obviously, to be in that top six is already a great achievement. So we're not 100%. Really discounting or discrediting anyone here. Who would be?
I know what he's going to say, but I know exactly what he's going to say. He's sixth place.
Really?
I don't want to go first because I might.
No, do it.
You've already started, bro.
Do it.
I think in my sixth place, I might go Deckers, you know.
Yeah.
Declan Rice.
Yeah. No. You didn't say Odegaard, did you?
Odegaard's in
Odegaard.
There. Odegaard. Okay. Who are you going?
I'm leaning towards Declan Rice. Saying Declan Rice at number six. As much as this hurts me to say, I think it's not.
Yeah.
Who would you say?
I was going to put Declan Rice higher up than that.
I know. Yeah. Okay, then I know what he was going to say. I thought you were going to say Bruno's not in there, is he?
Bruno is in
there. Yeah, I thought you were going to say Bruno.
Nah. I'm not going to say Bruno. I don't like the guy, but I'm not going to put him.
Fez.
Nah, if you want Fez.
The reason I put Declan Rice at number six, this hurts me as well.
Yeah, I wouldn't put him so high fire up.
The reason why is because he's not better than Rodri. That's facts. He's not better than Rodri. In that number six, he's not better than Rodri. Because the way Rodri controls the
game. He's not trying to get clipped up, man.
But no, he doesn't really mean this.
Just to be clear, we're not comparing sixes with sixes. It's just overall, as a player, who is better? So you think
Overall, as a player,
who is better? Not that we're comparing sixes with sixes, eights with eights.
With everything included, influence from their team, everything.
Everything included. Who would you rather have in your team? Who is the better player?
I'm still putting...
Do you know what? I think, for me, the six, and I'm going to ruin number five, but number six and number five is probably going to be Declan Rice and Rodri. And Jace, Rodri is of a bigger influence to City than Rice is to Arsenal. And the reason I'm saying that is because I'm only basing Rice's impact to Arsenal over this half stretch. And obviously, he has... Important winner at Luton, important winner at United. Yeah, I mean, he has so far shown that he's an impact player, but Rodri has a little bit more in the bank. When you think about last season, Rodri was phenomenal. This season as well, you see the difference about Rodri. They've gone winless for four games. When has City ever gone winless for four games?
So you think Bruno's better than Declan Rice? You think Odegaard's better than Declan Rice?
And also, like you said, based off of the last 18 months, they've had a better 18 months and we're talking strictly Premier League, right?
The individuals.
Individually, Odegaard's had a better 18 months.
Yeah, I want to backtrack. I want to stick with my first thing, who's Declan Rice as six.
Yeah.
Wow.
As much as that pains me, I don't think...
I was personally going to go with Odegaard as number six, but, you know, it's two against one here.
Yeah.
So I'll go with... No, because I was actually rating Rice a bit more. But fine, we'll go with Declan Rice in sixth place based on the last 18 months.
Right.
Yeah.
And then fifth place, we've got Declan Rice in six. He's out of there. Fifth place.
I'm going to say Odegaard.
Yeah, I would say Odegaard.
Yeah.
I'd say...
Don't you dare.
So it was Rice, Rodri, Bruno, Odegaard, Bernardo, and...
De Bruyne.
Okay. I'm going to say Bruno. Yeah, the reason I say Bruno is because this season, I don't feel like he's done much to stand out in that United team.
100% agree.
I feel like his output probably isn't at the level that it should be for a player that, you know, for his quality. Mm-hmm. And I feel like last year as well, I don't really remember him doing anything that really, you know, warranted any sort of team of the year type talk. Yeah. Okay. Any sort of... I'm pretty sure he got into double digits for assists, right?
Yeah. Always does.
Yeah, exactly. He always does. This is what I'm saying. But I don't think last year he was like, oh yeah, he was our standout player, or he was one of the top players in the league. I feel like the only reason he gets mentioned as top players in the league last year is off of merit of what he'd done in previous seasons since he came.
Can
I ask you though, when you're talking about output, do you mean when you're looking at stats, are you talking about assists or are you talking about chances created?
I'm talking about output. I'm talking about assists and goals. And I get chances created. You make a lot of chances. And I'm not trying to discredit that
player, a player doesn't know if they're going to get an assist. A player can try getting an assist. Yeah. But that's all down to the striker.
No,
the striker
gets
the assist. Or the person who scores the goal.
Or the person who scores the goal. No. They get the assist for the provider.
And I fully understand, which is why I'm not trying to like rub out that stat or anything like that. Mm. I'm just saying, I don't think last season was a great season for him. I feel like it was an okay season.
I understand what you're saying, but I think we need to pay more attention to that in terms of when you're a midfielder, your job is to get the ball to your forwards and create chances. Not necessarily get assists. Assists heavily is reliant on the person who scores the goal. Bruno, consistently, season after season, is the top midfielder for chances to create in the league, consistently. Mm-hmm. So you can't discredit what he does, which is why I feel like Bruno needs to be higher up. And again, looking at last season, we didn't have a forward, other than Marcus Rashford, we didn't have a forward scoring goals like that. Consistently. Martial, Anthony, whoever was playing up top for us, Ronaldo left, do you know what I mean? Even when Ronaldo was there, Bruno was providing so many assists for him in the Champions League. At some point in the Champions League, in the beginning stages, he was the highest of all teams in the Champions League for chance to create and assists. Mm. Do you know what I mean? So his quality is unmatched, and I just feel like him being that low is criminal. And I feel like I really, 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 really rate Ødegaard. Really do. I think he's the best player in the Arsenal team. A lot of Arsenal fans think Saka is, but he's not. Ødegaard's the best player in your team. But I just think in terms of this top six, this is where Ødegaard is. And I think fifth place is a very good achievement.
I'm sorry. I don't think you can put Bruno above Ødegaard. That's ridiculous to me. Only because of what Ødegaard did last season. Like, you can't.
Do you know what's funny, Max? He wanted to compare the stats. Yeah, he didn't see anything in his favor.
No,
deep man, man.
No, I didn't.
Deep man, man.
No, because I look. No,
deep man, man.
Is man all right? Do you know what I did on my phone? Do you know what I did? I went on last season's stats and I compared it and I said, do you know what? Yeah, look, bro, just chances created here. Big chances created. Bruno.
Whoa! Big chances created last season.
Bruno
41. Ødegaard 19.
Come on.
So more than double chances created by Bruno.
And look at what Ødegaard and Bruno have done. And this is why I did a range of from the start of last season till now. Yeah, Bruno in 53 games has 11 goals and 11 assists.
Okay.
Ødegaard in 3 less appearances in 50 games has 19 goals and 9 assists.
So
look at the differences in qualities in your team. Your strikers, your forwards are scoring these goals. We had one person last year that was scoring goals.
What's the main job of a cam?
As a cam, that's your creator in chief.
Okay, so Bruno has created more than double the chances of Ødegaard.
But
and that's their main job.
Ødegaard doesn't play the same way that Bruno plays. He doesn't.
Okay, and that's what makes Bruno a better player.
Anyway, it's 2-1 anyway. It's 2-1. It's 2-1.
It's 2-1.
Bias, you guys are cheating.
It's 2-1.
No.
Because
so we I need some Everton fans.
I was going to put Rice higher. You're the one that did that to yourself.
Some Liverpool fans or something.
Rice,
Ødegaard.
Nah, man.
Fourth place, I will say Bruno now.
That's ridiculous.
I'm torn between...
Bruno is not... Listen.
I'm torn between fourth and third. And the other person that I would bring to maybe say fourth would be Bernardo Silva. I feel like Bernardo Silva and like it's tough for me. I think I will put Bruno here, but I think like Bruno's that's not poor. That far behind Bernardo Silva in my that's opinion.
The thing is, yeah, I agree,
right?
And I think this proves our point about how you can't just look at goals and assists because. Mm. Bernardo Silva won't always get you that output in terms of goals and assists.
It's true though.
Wait. You can't always look at goals and assists.
And that's what so you're looking
so why are you bringing up all these other stupid stats for Bruno Fernandes?
Okay, thank you. Thank
Fuck
you.
That, man.
Because when I asked you...
I'm getting triggered now because I'm even mad.
You're proving the point exactly.
How?
I asked you, I said, what's the main job of a cam? And you said to create chances. So that's the stat I'm looking at. I'm not looking at how many goals or assists they get.
Okay, cool.
Because the assist that they get is dependent on their striker.
Aside of that, who's the better player? Who has more tech, Bruno or Ødegaard?
I think it's Bruno, personally. I see Bruno do some crazy things. Cool.
You see him do some crazy things? Like
yes.
What, Travella? That's a crazy thing.
If I'm just watching the game, I would say Ødegaard has more tech.
Ødegaard's
However,
better.
In terms of playing football, 11 against 11, who's going to create you chances? Bruno's going to do that. He's a better midfielder.
I think he might be a bit more well-rounded because I think maybe Bruno is a bit more stronger defensively than Ødegaard.
Yeah.
When it comes to pressing, you can't touch Ødegaard. Ødegaard is press proven and he's the one that even kickstarts the press for us as well. So there's that side of the game
and
as well.
And Bruno doesn't kickstart our press.
And then he starts strapping around and getting yellow cards.
Yeah, but
we need to go to the next one.
I say Bruno here as well.
Whatever, put Bruno there, innit?
Yeah, Bruno's there then. So sixth place, we have Rice. Fifth place, we have Ødegaard. Fourth place, we have Bruno. Third place.
This is where Bernardo Silva goes for me.
Yeah, Bernardo Silva.
Yeah, okay.
Bernardo Silva, can we just talk about him quickly? Because I don't think he gets the credit he deserves. He's a very, 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 very good midfielder, good player. And I just feel like when you play in a Pep team, the amount of rotations you get, you don't get a lot of the plaudits that you deserve. There's mainstays in the team like, obviously, De Bruyne and Haaland that will get the plaudits. But everyone around them, they're very good players in their own right. And if you pick them up and drop them another team, you'll see their quality for what they really are. And I think Bernardo Silva is one that people kind of brush past, like, oh, he's a Pep player. No, he's a fantastic player. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So
he's someone that to me will start for pretty much any team in the world.
I think he's one of those players that he's just a footballer, a very good footballer. It doesn't matter where you play. And I remember last season when it was at the Emirates and Pep started him at left back. And I was like, what the fuck's Pep doing, bro? But he played that role so well. And I feel like that role for him was just to disrupt Saka on that right wing, foul him, and just build play from that side. Until second half, switched him to the right wing, brought on Ake. And even when he was playing right wing, Bernardo was sort of on the wings. You can't tackle him.
One of the best dribblers I've seen on the ball.
I think he's probably I think he might be one of the best football players in the Premier League.
Definitely, every single
position, I think he's so gifted. He's ridiculous.
I agree.
It's just that his impact obviously isn't as strong as someone like Kevin De Bruyne or whatever.
And that leads us on to another person that impacts City that is going my second, which would be Rodri.
Yeah, 100%.
I think we've seen over the last couple of weeks how important Rodri is to that City team, how important he is in terms of influencing games, influence the Champions League final. He's just that type of player that you need, that mainstay in your team, that spine of City. As we said, it goes with obviously Edison, wherever the centre-back he picks. But then after that, it's Rodri, De Bruyne, Haaland. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
When you have that spine in your team, it's different. And I think Rodri's just a fantastic player. I mean, I love him at United.
And I think one thing that people don't realise, first of all, that guy's a crook because he's the king of tactical fouls. He never gets booked.
Learned from Fernandinho, man.
Huh?
He learned from Fernandinho.
Honestly, learned from one of the best. But I think what his main skill is just the fact that he's able to read situations long before they happen. Mm-hmm. And I feel like he's the perfect midfielder that someone like Barcelona need. He's like that Busquets type of air where, their stature and their frame, obviously Busquets are quite thin, Rodri's a bit more built, but they're not athletic players. Mm. You know what I mean? They're not the fastest, they're not necessarily the strongest or whatnot, but their reading of the game, their anticipation of different situations and the ability to dictate the tempo and just sort of do that seamless kind of transition from defence to attack is second to none. And like Mike said, we're seeing the difference without them. People are like running through City. It's crazy.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Leading on to number one, I think you can
can't discredit him.
Kevin De Bruyne.
One of the best players in Premier League history, you know.
Mm.
Maybe even the best centre mid in Premier League history. He's definitely in that debate. He's definitely Man City's greatest player ever.
Ain't much to choose from.
Come on.
They've got two great players that are going to go down in Premier League history, which would be De Bruyne and Aguero.
Yeah.
You know, and David Silva as well.
And David's...
Yeah, and company. And David's, yes, he will. Anyway, fine.
But it's one of those ones that, listen, De Bruyne is class, and it seems like him being out from City team, it didn't seem like it's impacted City so much in terms of their chances created. However, his quality on the ball, any team, big game, small game, he's going to perform. He's just one of those players that he really is that player. So can't discredit him. And it seems like when City are starting to lose games, they're giving him that injection to get back on the field. Bro, he's coming back very soon. So
he's going
to
come back like one of the soldiers or something.
But yeah, but man.
I want, before we round up though, I want to give a quick shout out to two midfielders who didn't make the list, one from a top six team and one from that isn't from a top six team. Mm. I'm going to say Partey. I think he's top 10. Do you know what I mean? I feel like he's a very good player on his day. I think his thing is just that he doesn't stay fit. Mm. And the second player I'm going to give props to is Douglas Luiz. I feel like Douglas Luiz,
because he's going to be an Arsenal player. Is he he's trying to get in there?
If he is, then I don't mind. I'm smiling. But no, Douglas Luiz, I've been a fan of him kind of since he made the switch from City, because he was part of the City group teams. I think he was in Girona on loan, and it made permanent, and then Aston Villa bought him. And I remember seeing him in his first scene. I was like, oh, he seems kind of confident on the ball, but he was a bit rough around the edges. And I feel like now he's a bit more refined. He knows his game, and he's a very, very good player. And I feel like, obviously, if we are lucky enough to get him over in January in the summer, that would be a great addition. But I feel like someone like you guys would definitely benefit from a player 100%. Like Douglas Luiz. I feel like he needs to make that move this summer.
And that's
exactly why
Man United won't go for him, because we're just dumb.
Do you know what I mean? When he makes that move to that bigger team, you're going to properly see Douglas Luiz for the baller 100%. He is. Mm-hmm. So do you want to give the man his props?
100%.
Give the man his flowers.
100%. 100%.
Yeah. All right. So that's our top five. We hope you've enjoyed it. In the comments, tell us your top five. Have you got someone wrong? Have you missed someone out? You know, I can hear someone in the background saying Madison. I don't know. You let us know.
Ooh.
As always, subscribe
to
the channel.
Run for it one more time.
So we did, we put six. Ødegaard in sixth.
No, Rice. No.
We put Rice in sixth place. Ødegaard in fifth place. In fourth place, we put
Bruno.
In third place, we put Bernardo Silva. Second, Rodri. And first place, De Bruyne. Just remember, this is based on the last 18 months. It's not just this season, not just last season. It's based on the last 18 months. But as always, give this video a like, comment and subscribe. Follow us on Twitter, TikTok and Instagram as well, so you can stay in touch with us. And as always, tell a friend to tell a friend.
Peace.